वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी डिफरेंट फिजियोकेमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज एंड अमंग दिस प्रॉपर्टी वन ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. वी विल सी इन डिटेल रिगार्डिंग द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ ड्रग मॉलिक्यूल. लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, स्टूडेंट शुड एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड physiochemical properties of drug molecules and able to describe the interaction of liquid with liquids and application and determination of refractive index and molar refraction. Physiochemical properties of drug molecules, the ability of chemical compound to elicit a pharmacological or therapeutical effect is related to influence of various physical and chemical properties of the chemical substance on a biological molecule that interact with. Okay, means pharmacological effect of your drug molecule, it depends on the different physical and chemical property of your drug molecule. One of them is refractive index, then optical rotation, dielectric constant, then dipole moment, dissociation constant, these are the different physiochemical properties, and depending on this that physiochemical properties your drug will give you pharmacological effect. Now we'll see refractive index. Refractive index is defined as a ratio of velocity of light in vacuum to the velocity of light in the substance at the same wavelength is known as the refractive index. It is nothing but ratio of the light in vacuum, velocity of light in vacuum to velocity of light in the substance at same wavelength. Refractive index is dependent on color of the light traveling through the medium and also depending on density of your medium. White light is made up of light of different colors. Then as per Snell's law, the relationship between the angle of incidence and angle of reflection of light through the material as per the Snell's law, a light travel from first medium to second medium, the ratio of the sine angle of incidence to the sine angle of refraction is a constant and called as the refractive index. This ratio of sine angle of incidence and sine angle of refraction is constant. This is your first medium, this is your second medium. Your incident ray falls on these boundaries and get change their path. This is your angle of incidence, this is your normal line, and the angle formed by your light to your normal line will give you angle of incidence. Then this is your angle of refraction. As per the Snell's law, refractive index n is equal to sine of these I divided by sine of r, that is sine of incidence ray to sine of refraction ray is always constant for two medium. Sine theta 1 divided by sine theta 2 is equal to v1 upon v2, that is equal to n2 upon n1. V is the velocity, n is the refractive index. And with the rearrangement of this equation, we can write n1 sin theta 1 is equal to n2 sin theta 2. N is the refractive index of first material, n2 is the refractive index of second material. The law is used in ray tracing to compute the angle of incidence or a refraction, and in experimental topics and gemmology to find the refractive index of a material. If you see this diagram carefully, when you dip your pencil into the water, it looks like that. Why it is happen? Because angle of incidence changes its path when it transferred from one medium to another medium. That's why pencil looks like bent. Then factors affecting on the refractive index. First is the temperature. As the temperature, we have a smaller value for refractive index at high temperature. Means your refractive index decreases as the temperature increases. Ratio of your sine angle of incidence to ratio to the sine angle of refraction is decreases. That's why value of your refractive index is also decreases. At lower temperature, refractive index is high because your medium become dense as the temperature decreases. That's why your refractive index will be high. Now, second parameter for these refractive index, that is wavelength of light. Refractive index varies with wavelength linearity because different wavelength interfere to different extent with atom of the molecules. Means wavelength of the light should be constant. Then pressure, refractive index increases with pressure due to accompanying rise of density. Okay, as pressure increases, density increases and your refractive index ultimately increases. The use of this refractive index, it is used to measure the concentration of solute in an aqueous solution. For a solution of sugar, the refractive index can be used to determine the sugar content. It is also used to calculate focusing power of lenses and dispersive power of prism. It is used to identify a particular substances, since refractive index is a fundamental physical property of a substance. It is also calculated for the checking of purity of your substance. Now we'll move towards the actual instrumentation part, that is the Abbe's refractometer is used to determine the refractive index of substance. The liquid sample is sandwiched into a thin layer between an illuminating prism and refracting prism. Refracting prism is made up of glass with high refractive index up to 1.75. And the refractometer is designed to be used with sample having a refractive index smaller than this prism. Means we can measure the refractive index of substance which is having a value less than that this refracting prism, and it is 1.75. So this is the illuminating prism, this is your refracting prism, and in between these two prisms you have to put your sample. Then pass the light, and in this way the refraction of light is there. Your refractometer looks like this. This consists of lamp part, then the illuminating prism. Okay, this is the open part. Here you have to put your sample and you have to close it. Then this is adjustment hand wheel. Then this is thermometer to measure the temperature. This is your compensator dial to adjust the view. This is your eyepiece. These are the parts of your refractometer. This is your instrumentation part, that is the eyepiece. Then it consists of telescope. Then two MSC prisms are there. These are the two MSC prisms. This is your measuring prism and illuminating prism. As I said you in the previous diagram, this is your light source. Light source fall on these light, and in between this measuring prism and illuminating prism, you have to put your sample. Then it passes through the pair of MSC prism, and then you will get the reading. When you see from your refractometer, your view like that. This is the circular diagram. Will show you some lines, and this is your scale. Means it consists of two eyepieces. One is for scale, and one is for the adjustment of your view. The average instrument is most convenient and widely used refractometer. The sample is contained a thin layer, that is 0.1 mm. Means your illuminating prism and a refracting prism having the 0.1 mm area to put your sample in between these two. Upper prism is firmly mounted and that allows rotation by means of sidearm. Hinges are there, and with the help of hinges you have to open this space and apply the sample. The lower prism is hinged to upper prism and permit the separation for cleaning as well as sample introduction. The lower prism face is rough ground. When light is reflected into the prism, this surface effectively becomes source for an infinite number of rays that pass through a sample at all angles. The radiation is reflected at the interface of the sample and smooth ground face of upper prism. After this, it passes into fixed telescope having the two MSC prisms rotated with respect to another in search to collect the divergent critical angle of different color into single white beam that corresponds in path to that of the sodium rays. A typical MSC prism consists of two triangular prisms. If you see the diagram carefully, it consists of three prisms in a single MSC prism, and it is made up of medium dispersion crown glass and high dispersion flint glass. Eyepiece of telescope is provided with crosshair in making a measurement, and the prism angle is changed until light dark interface just coincides with crosshair. Means you have to adjust your view in such a way that half part will be dark and half part will be light. The position of MSC prism is then established from fixed thermo setting, is accomplished by circulating the water through jacket surrounding the prism. Okay, how can you measure the refractive index? First of all, you have to clean the surface of prism with alcohol and then or acetone. then for the acetone, using cotton and allow to dry. Then using dropper, you have to put 2 to 3 drop of your sample in between these two prism. Then allow the light to fall on mirror. Adjust the mirror to reflect maximum light onto the prism box where you have kept your sample. Then rotate the prism box by moving lever until the boundaries between shaded and bright part appears in a field of view. If band of color disappear in a light shade boundary, make it sharp by rotating the compensator. Then now what you have to do, you have to first of all clean it with alcohol, then acetone, then put the sample drops with the help of dropper in between these two prism. Then you have to adjust the mirror in such a way that more light reflection is there, and then you have to rotate your prism and you have to set your eyepiece view in a such a way that half part will be dark and half will be light. For that purpose, you have to move the rotating compensator. Then adjust the lever so that light shade boundary passes exactly through the center of the crosshair. Read the refractive index directly on the scale. Okay, now if you have ready with the setting, then directly you have to go through the second eyepiece, which will give you the reading. Take a 3 set of readings and find the average of all these 3 readings. Here I put the example of some chemicals. Glycerin is having 1.67, paraffin oil 1.43, then turpentine is having 1.47 refractive index, then water 1.34, ethanol 1.35, carbon tetrachloride 1.46, then petrol is having 1.44, chloroform 1.43, and benzene is having 1.50 refractive index. This is all about the physicochemical properties and a refractive index of the substance. Thank you.